Before using an oxy-acetylene torch, you must ensure that you're wearing all the necessary PPE. This will be safety glasses of varying types depending on the application, safety shoes, and a buttoned-up protective smock or overalls. Long hair should be tied up. Festival bands and dangling jewellery should be removed, and all clothing tassels, long hair, etc. tucked safely away. An oxy-acetylene torch is a flame torch where two gases are mixed and then ignited to provide heat to enable us to perform a variety of different processes. The torch rests on a cradle that turns off the gas supply when not in use, and it's lit with a pilot light. When the torch is lifted from the cradle, the gas supply is turned on. To light the torch, pull the nozzle backwards through the flame. It's important that the nozzle is pulled backwards. If the torch is pushed through the flame, the force of the gas pressure will attempt to extinguish the pilot light and the torch won't light properly. If this happens, you'll hear the difference in the sound of the burning torch. You don't need to start again, simply pull the nozzle through the pilot light to correct the problem. The torch flame should have a clear and defined blue cone within the overall flame. This is referred to as a neutral flame. If it's too sharp and ice blue, then there's an excess of oxygen. Reduce the oxygen by gently turning the blue tap on the torch in a clockwise direction. If the blue cone is undefined and feathering around the edges, then there's an excess of acetylene. Reduce the acetylene by gently turning the red tap in a clockwise direction. Either tap can be turned gently in an anti-clockwise direction to increase the level of respective gases going into the mixing chamber. To extinguish the torch, simply return it to the cradle. Carefully and gently rest the red tap into the crook of the cradle, ensuring it's seated safely before taking your hand away. The flame will fade slowly. Wait until it's totally extinguished before leaving the work area.